Boston Public Health Commission raised the city's West Nile virus risk from low to moderate. We need to talk to you about that.
And as you can see here to answer your questions is Dr. Todd Ellerin. He's the vice chair of medicine at South Shore Health. He's here in the house. The doctor's in the house with us today. So, Dr. T, the bulletin warns that people may be getting infected with West Nile without even knowing it. Hmm. So is there a risk, and what's the risk here?
First of all, you made me very relaxed with the last
good.
Segment.
We were breathing with you, right?
The good news is the risk is extremely low of severe disease. Getting infected is not uncommon, but the truth of the matter is only about 1 in 150 people will have more severe symptoms. And even when you look at deaths over the past 20 years, there's only been about 2,000 in the United States. It's about 100 a year. In Massachusetts, in any given year, there may be somewhere between 7 and 42 cases in a very busy year. So overall, it's something that fortunately is rare. Severe disease, at least.
So most people have just mild symptoms and they do recover on their own. So when should people really be concerned?
It's important to know this, even though I said it's rare. Maria, the key is, you know, fevers are common, headache is common, but if you start seeing that a loved one's confused or has neck stiffness, severe headache, right, and you know they've been outside recently, maybe have had some mosquito bites, then you want to seek medical attention.
Dr. T, great to see you. Have a great weekend. Thanks
for coming. And sleep well, doctor.
You too.
Remember those five steps.